Let's talk about hair, baby. Let's talk about kinks and naps and all that stuff. Let's talk about hair. Hello, beauties. Hello, champions. It's me, Jay of Nappy Beauty. Hello. Happy Sunday. Okay. Whew. It's been a full Sunday. I tell you, it's been a full Sunday. But I just wanted to talk to you guys quickly. And I don't know why I said quickly, because sometimes it turns not so quickly. But anyway, I am excited about just knowing and coming into my purpose. I know a lot of you might not know what your purpose is. You might be searching and longing to know what your purpose is. But I tell you, I was listening to one of Oprah's life classes. It's an old life class. And she was talking about, because I watched the whole series, which was wonderful. If you haven't seen it, catch up on it, go online or go on to the OWN network and look at it, because those were some great classes. So I encourage you to go there. But anyway, this particular one was talking about knowing your purpose and Lady Gaga and how she found her purpose, and that her, all this outwardly, I know, outrageous, over the top that you see of Lady Gaga, her real purpose is having people be who they are and just live in that. So I thought that was really touching, and I just really became someone that really thinks Lady Gaga is like awesome. She's talented. She's got, I mean, the girl can sing, and she's just out there. She doesn't care what people think. I saw her Monster Ball, and that's when I really saw that, wow, she is really talented. She has great music. And she's really talented. Before that, I just heard her name, didn't know who she was, wasn't, you know, listening to her music or anything. But when I looked at that and I stopped to take off, you know, that perception that you hear or you see, or you already have a notion of what you think someone's going to be like, and I took that away and just watched, and I was blown away. Really blown away. So this just leads me into what I want to talk about today. Is, you know, we have to be careful about judging the book by its cover. And, you know, looking at someone and thinking that, oh, you know, or even ourselves, how we dress this cover and what people perceive us to be. You know, we just have to be careful about that and spend time with people and let go of the notion of what you think they are. I, for one, is the type of person, I have so many different types of friends, so many nationalities, ages. I just have a lot of people that I enjoy being around. And a lot of them look like me. A lot of them don't look like me. And I love that, because I love people. And I love the perception of, you know, having like a United Nation, or just being able to have so many different ethnic groups and cultures, and being able to learn stuff from different people that, you know, I perceive or might be perceived in my life as, that's something she wouldn't do. Why she hang out with that type of person? But what's going on with that? I love having that, because it makes you open as a person, and it makes you more acceptable of other people. So I said I was going to talk about your purpose and getting there. Sometimes we, as Oprah stated, we think that our purpose has to be this big, grand, famous, or got all this money, or da-da-da-da. Sometimes your purpose isn't even that. You know, I am a big person about kindness. Kindness means a lot to me. And if I'm with someone, say I'm out with a guy, we go to dinner, and if he's rude to the waitress or rude to the attendant or whatever, I don't like that. And that person won't get my attention or respect, because you're rude to people you see as beneath you. So kindness is a big thing for me. And I'll watch that. I am over a couple of groups, and one of my groups, this lady wanted to speak. And she came over and told me about, oh, what she can do, and da da da. And then I turned to her and I asked her, I said, well, that's great. You have some wonderful skills. I am going to do this thing for some children that's in Job Corps that need skills like yours. Do you think that you can help? And she goes, that's really not my clientele, and I don't think that I'll be really helpful with that. But you just want to talk to my business ladies about your thing, but you're not willing to give of yourself to somebody that may not can afford you, but could benefit from you. You will never speak to my group. Never. Because this is what I look for. I look for kindness. Not saying that everybody has to. Yes, it is. Everybody should do something charitable. You shouldn't always look for a paycheck in the thing you do. You should have things that you just readily give away. Here you go. Give it away. Because when you give stuff away, you get things. People are really apt to give you when you are a giver. So, it's really more of a rant than what my purpose is. But I'm just full today, and I think about that because I feel like, you know how when you feel like you're coming of yourself, you know that all the pieces are coming together? I just feel that moment happening now. And I talk about that because, you know, we've been on this weight loss journey. We've been on It's My Journey, I Am an MJ journey. And it's not just about weight loss. And I've been saying that for so long. My whole journey, this physical part that I'm fighting against, is not about the weight loss. And what I have come to understand is it's not a fight. It's more of a submission. And understanding yourself, accepting yourself for what you are right now, today. And stop wishing for the future self. And what's gonna happen when you get. I talked about the Win Club last week, and I don't do the Win Club. I am in the presence. But what I do is I look for perfectionists. Perfection in everything. I'm a perfectionist. And if I don't have certain things together, I don't want to go out there in the world. I wanna wait. But you know what that is? That's a form of sabotage. Because not anyone on this green earth has everything they need to step out. You don't have it. That's why you step out. And God brings the people and the things and the moments that you need to build yourself more and more and more. So I'm learning to let go of this perfectionistic attitude that I think I need everything perfect. It needs to look a certain way. I need to have this, or it's just not together. I just be together and ready for opportunities, then everything else will come. So I'm talking to all of you out there that might be perfectionists, might live in the Win Club, might talk down to yourself, might not think that you're living in your purpose. Even if you don't know what your purpose is, just help someone. Just help someone, and I guarantee you, you'll get closer to your purpose. Be good at whatever it is you're in now. You might be in a job you hate. You might be in a job that you just don't get any joy out of at all. But do it well and be present. And I tell you, things will happen that will blow your mind. Blow your mind. I'm just going to mention a couple things to you guys right now about things that's happening in my life. I have a nonprofit group I'm getting off the ground, and it's hard. It's in honor of my mother, who had the greatest heart of the world. She was just a giver. She gave everything. She gave of herself when there was nothing to give. She did that. And yeah, she passed that down to me. But I just say that to say, you know, I've always done like the back to school drive, and I added Dress the Soul to give away shoes. And now I just put it in a form that is all one thing. But I have this whole platform of what I want to do to help others. And I'm just so excited and bubbling over about it. And I'm so amazed because, like I said, do what you're doing right now and do it excellently. And then everything else will come together. And I say that because I am just amazed at the things that's happening with Annie's heart. I'm amazed. We have a drive coming up next week where I'm giving away shoes and toys, and I'm just bubbling over with the people we're going to help. And the people are going to touch, I'm bubbling over for that. Not only that, I told you guys I had, I don't know if I told you, but because I keep hinting at it, but I never really talk about it. I have a company where I create natural hair products. Love it. Being able to help women get to where they want to go with their natural hair. Transitioning for us is can be a nightmare because you're not used to looking at yourself in the mirror and seeing yourself and saying, oh, I'm beautiful. This is good. I can go with this. It's a transition. It's a whole mindset that you have to go through. And when I went through it, I know I had my friend on standby and I was like, oh my God, I'm not going outside today. But I made it through. And in doing that, I want to help other people make it through and find things that are good for their hair. So in creating my product line, it was just trial and error and what I liked and what felt good on my hair. And in doing that, I have a whole another clientele. I have Jewish clients, white clients. I have, oh my God. I can't even think. So many different hair types and cultures and ethnic groups and people that I wasn't even thinking about in creating this. I was thinking about me and my needs and what can I do to help my hair. And once I found that, I just asked my friends, try this. Tell me what you think. And I've been blown away by that. So I'm just telling you guys these bits and pieces of my life that's coming together. You know, this whole time of doing all this, I've been homeless. And I don't know how many of my new subscribers know that. And my old ones, I haven't even talked about it lately. But I'm still homeless. It takes a whole lot to create my product now because I have my friend's kitchens I'm using and I have to hug all this stuff around. But you know what? I'm never going to give up. I'm going to keep pushing because I know my destiny is there. I know my purpose in life is to help and reach others and encourage. And this is why YouTube is so wonderful for me because I get to encourage and touch and talk to so many people that it just brings me joy. Every Sunday that I'm here, it brings me joy. Every hump day that I get up here, it brings me joy. And I just want to share that with you. Okay, guys, I'm a little full. I think I shared a lot. And I have to tell you guys about IMJ is getting ready to do a cruise 2013. And I hope you guys are excited about it. I'm going to tell you how you can join me on a cruise in 2013. It's my journey. We're going to have so much fun. We're going to do some drop-offs in two different countries. I want you guys to get excited with me. Pass this on. Tell people about IMJ. Tell people about Nappy Beauty. Tell them about Jay. And by the way, my real name is Joyce. I do go by Jay, so you guys keep calling me Jay. But it's so much on the horizon, and I'm ready to just explode and tell you guys about it. So keep your focus. Keep going. Keep pushing. Never give up. And know that working on yourself for weight loss or what have you, it's more than the weight loss. It's more than the weight loss. And remember to always help somebody. That's all I have to say today. I'll talk to you guys soon. Let's talk about hair, baby. Let's talk about kinks and naps and all that stuff. Let's talk about hair. That was a mouthful, right? Keep it moving, keep it positive. And I'll see you guys soon. Keep it moving, keep it positive. Don't let anyone stop you from going where you need to go. People are waiting on you to arrive. Do it.